हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू शॉर्ट एंड सुपर फास्ट राइटर्स। दोस्तों, आप इस चैनल को सब्सक्राइब कर लें और बेल आइकन को दबाएं डेली शॉर्ट एंड डिक्टेशंस के लिए। आज के मैटर की ट्रांसक्रिप्शन के लिए आप डिस्क्रिप्शन की लिंक पर जा सकते हैं, और इस तरह की और भी डिक्टेशंस लिखने के लिए आप हमारे प्लेलिस्ट पर भी जा सकते हैं। शुरू करते हैं आज का डिक्टेशन। ट्रांसक्रिप्शन नंबर 210, वॉल्यूम नंबर 10 से एसएससी स्टेनोग्राफर ग्रेड सी के लिए। बी रेडी। 10 सेकेंड्स। 5 सेकेंड्स। 5 सेकेंड्स स्टार्ट। द इशू रियली इज वेदर हायर एडुकेशन कैन बी बेस्ड मेयरली ऑन ट्रांसलेशंस। Translations are important, and in many countries where the languages do not provide adequate textbooks, the conveying of thought is done through the personal medium, and the quality of teachers is the thing that really matters in the development of thought and in the development of books. Therefore, while I strongly support the idea that there should be a concerted policy for translations and for the production of books on every subject, I do not know whether it would be possible for me to vote for a committee at this stage for this purpose, when various organizations are already functioning, including the National Book Trust and the various academies which exist and which are backed not only by the state governments but to a certain extent by the central government also. There is a further point which I would like to emphasize, and it is this. There is this idea that in scientific, humanistic and other subjects, translation is merely the result of the backwardness of a language. The Honorable Minister for Scientific Research and Cultural Affairs has just now pointed out the number of translations that have taken place into the English language. From every language, books are translated into English, French, German, Russian, and so on. It is not a hallmark of our advancing desire to popularize knowledge. It is not given to a single language to have the monopoly of wisdom, the monopoly of knowledge, the monopoly of research. This is being done in every language, in every important language. And what is necessary for us is to accumulate that knowledge and to bring the quantum of that knowledge from various languages into our own languages, not merely for the purpose of school textbooks, but in order that the ordinary person, in order that the public at large may have a source from which to draw upon for their own knowledge. The idea that books are meant only for schools and only for teachers to teach and students to cram, I think, is a very primitive one. What is important is that with national documentation developing in the country, books should be looked upon as the main source for the rising of standards and the intellectual level of the common people. You may have popular series like the Home University Library or similar books or standard volumes written especially and at higher prices. What is required is that works on the latest topics, science, social sciences, all these must be available for the common man and not merely for the students in the colleges. Students in colleges have set courses, they study set things. If they have not got the books, the teachers are there to explain to them what the books contain. I do not want to give very much importance to this idea that teachers should teach through textbooks. If teachers are well educated, if teachers know their subjects, they would teach through classics and not through textbooks. Textbooks are merely made very easy in order to get through the examinations. What is important is that the teacher should know the subject well and he should be in a position to explain the intricacies to students who learn. The issue that we have to face clearly is this. When we have a developing system of education, when year by year the number of students in our schools and colleges increases by millions, it is not possible to keep the standards we had when our college going numbers were very small. At the same time, it is necessary that the standard not merely in colleges but the standard of knowledge, of information, of critical values must continue to rise if democracy has to function, and therefore it is not merely a question of producing textbooks. It is a question of producing good books, and good books in ample numbers to be made available at cheap prices to people who are educated. Actually, we come back to this question, that is the problem of continuing to educate the educated. It is not merely a question of educating the people in colleges, because science is daily progressing, research work in social sciences is daily improving, in economics, in history, in all these subjects there are daily improvements in knowledge. The fact that you took a degree or came through a university with distinction some time ago does not make you an educated man. It is necessary that you should keep in touch with those things so that the standard of knowledge continues to permeate all at all levels, even the educated people. For this purpose, what is required is that at latest knowledge should be made available in books, not merely in books, but in the best kind of books, and not merely by translation. Translation can only enrich a language up to a point. Translations are useful as producing a quantum of work for purposes of knowledge. Sir, after long discussions, we are about to pass this bill. Many of our suggestions have not been accepted, and we shall continue to press them in future whenever we get a chance. As you know, even before this measure came, I brought in an amendment to Section 293 prohibiting donations to political parties. We may do it from this side of the House through private members' bill. Now I will make a few suggestions. Whatever little improvements have been made, despite the fact that they have not gone very far at all, very much will depend on how the law is administered. And we find from our experience that whenever a measure of this kind is passed, continuing neither so bad nor so good provisions, they are not properly implemented. There are certain provisions in the bill which are important, and they should be enforced. We can enforce them. Sir, great responsibility devolves on the Department of Company Affairs. So thanks for watching. Do like, subscribe and share.